गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, आई रश्मि मैम इज अगेन बैक विथ योर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस और यू कैन से ऑनलाइन सेशन फॉर क्लास 8, सब्जेक्ट इज बायोलॉजी. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ चैप्टर 2, दैट इज सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड यूनिसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट आवर सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट. Asexual reproduction in plant was being described in a very different types. There was asexual reproduction in many different ways, which has been completed. Now we are going to start our sexual reproduction. Now sexual reproduction takes place by the formation of gametes. Two parents are needed to give rise to a new individual plant, or you can say a flower. Means over here, sexual reproduction has to be combined with two plants, then only they can give rise to a new individual. Otherwise, they can't do that. So flowering plants are also called angiosperm, use a sexual mode of reproduction. These angiosperm plants use sexual mode of reproduction. Reproduction in plants mainly revolves around the flower. Reproduction in plants, where it revolves, it only and only revolves around the flower, which consists of both the male and female gametes. Over it has been given in your book. Takes place by the formation of gametes. So the gametes are male and female reproductive system. So both the system, male and female gametes, are present only and only in the flower. All parts of a flower aid in the process of reproduction. Means flower is the main reproductive organ of any flowering plant, or you can say any angiosperm. Only flower consists of all parts which take part in the process of reproduction. Although some of them are sterile, therefore to understand the process of reproduction in flowering plants, we need to look at different parts of a flower and their function. Which these things you have studied earlier also in class 6, in class 7 also, and briefly now we are going to study in our class 8. In class 6, there is the basic knowledge, in class 7, little bit larger, and in class 8, it should be the detail, which gives you a more important information, which will help you in class 9. So, in this sexual reproduction, which happens only in the flowering plants, or you can say in the angiosperm, which consists of both the male and female gametes and all the parts of a flower, is being involved in the process of reproduction. So, thus to understand this whole procedure, we have to go through the flower, the reproductive part of the plant. In class 6, you have studied that flower is a reproductive part of a plant. It forms seed that give rise to a new plant. So, flower is only the thing which gives the seed, and these seeds gives rise to a new plant. A complete flower has following whorls. Now, you can say the parts of the flower or the four whorls of the flower, which are the main reproductive organ of the flower. That is calyx, corolla, androecium and the gynoecium. These are the four whorls which take part in this whole process of reproduction. Now we are going to read all these things in a very brief manner. First, we are going to study about the first whorl, that is calyx. The outermost whorl of a flower. It is consists of five or more green leaf-like sepals, which protect inner parts of flower in the bud stage. Now over here the word sepals. So the calyx can be also known as sepals. So calyx or the sepals are the first whorl of the flower, or you can say the outermost whorl of a flower. It comprises in a bud stage. Calyx encloses the rest of the flower. They are usually exhibit green coloration in some cases. They may be a color like petals. This condition of calyx is termed as petaloid. Calyx can either be prominent or absent. In some flowers you can find calyx, and in some flower you cannot find calyx. So these are in the bunch of five or more green leaf structure which protect the inner parts of flower, in which stage? In the bud stage, at which time it is in the form of bud. The flower, when it is in the time of bud stage, that time these calyx, which are green leafy like structure, consist of five, they are being used as the protective layer for all parts, or you can say for all the inner parts of the flower. So this was the calyx, known as also sepals. Now the second we are going to read about corolla, the second whorl of the flower. Now corolla is the second whorl of the flower, and it consists of many numbers of petals. So corolla is also known as petals. Corolla is also known as petals. So the another name of corolla is petal, and it is the second whorl of the flower. This is consist of five or more bright colored petals which attract insects, birds, mammals for pollination of flower. So we know that these corolla are being in the five or more brightly colored petals having fragrant, which used as to attract animals, insects, birds, mammals for the purpose of pollination. These petals are very thin colored, soft, in a bunch of 5 to 6, and having fragrant, that's why animals, insects, birds, mammals, all are being attracted to these petals, or you can say these corolla, for the process of pollination. Now the third we are going to read, that is androecium, which is the reproductive structure of a flower. Androecium, which is the reproductive structure of a flower. Now androecium, which is known as male reproductive part of a flower, which is known as male reproductive part of a flower, consisting of stamens, and it is the third whorl. Each stamen comprises two parts, namely anther and filament. The tip of the anther is supported by the filament. Here pollens are produced by meiosis and disappear eventually. Now this androecium is the third whorl of the flower, and it is the male reproductive part of a flower consisting of stamens. Each stamen is formed of a sac-like apical anther and a long, slender, tube-like structure that is called filament. Pollen grains are formed inside the anther. They contain male gametes. Now, the swollen portion, or you can say the sac-like apical tip, is the anther and is supported by the filament, which is tube-like structure. Hair pollens are produced by meiosis and disappear eventually. Now, what is anther? Anther is a four-lobed sac-like structure responsible for pollen formation. Now, what is this anther? Anther is a four-lobed sac-like structure responsible for pollen formation. Now, what is filament? These filament are thread-like structure are attached to the anther and they keep the anther in place. These filaments are tube-like structure, or you can say thread-like structure, which are attached to the anther and keep the anther in a place. The transverse section of an anther is microsporangia that further forms a pollen sac. The pollen sac contains pollen grains. What pollen sac contains? Pollen grains. Now we are going to read about the transverse section of an anther, which is known as microsporangia.